I'm from DC.
DC? Oh, that's far.
It's not too far, like 4 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Just
right
to the left.
Okay, great. Thank you. This is pretty nice. My friend is in the other room, right here. It's a nice little living room. I'm staying in here because I didn't want to wake them up coming in so late. And then this is the bathroom. Very nice. Sweet. Alright, time to sleep. Need to get up at 4 a.m. for our first thing tomorrow, which I'm so excited to show you guys. I'm ready for bed now. I just checked into the hotel. And we're at the hotel in Valley Hills. So I just got done showering and put on my skincare stuff. And now to figure out what to wear for tomorrow because it's gonna be a long day. But I cannot wait to show you guys what's in store for the next couple days in Phoenix. This is my first time here, so I'm very excited. And I can't wait to show you guys. So stay tuned. Good night. Good morning, everyone. So it's like 4:40 in the morning, and we are on our way to the first event of the day. I want to show you guys what that is. Hello. We are on our girls trip to Phoenix. Say hi.
Hi.
You know this girl. Guess what we'll be doing? Because it's like 6 a.m. in the morning, but we were up since like 4. But we are. Hello. We are so excited. This is my first time in a hot air balloon. I am so stoked. Can't wait to show what it looks like up here. And it's actually really freezing too.
Because they can still hear super high frequencies. We can't as adults.
Getting my mileage in.
How they came to make a hot air balloon is kind of a silly story. They're paper makers, and the Frenchmen that were the paper makers were out back burning paper scraps. And when they threw scraps of paper into the fire, is that enough? When they threw scraps of paper into the fire, they realized that the embers would rise up and fly away. So when it rose up and flew away, they realized that there's some sort of lifting agent there causing...
Just a little bit.
Good?
Yeah.
Causing the paper to fly away. So they looked at the fire and they could see Uptown Scottsdale. It's very nice.
They forgot all about it.
So I just got the certificate for the hot air balloon.
I have to offer. Mm-hmm.
My last name has changed.
Never did. You do?
It's okay. So we're at Taliesin West, which is one of Frank Lloyd Wright's work. Apparently it's a studio too, so touring the place.
I'll tell you a little bit about Mr. Wright's personal life. The only wife that ever lived here was his third wife. On in to Mr. Wright's office, one of the original structures.
You guys, I got the salmon salad bowl and it looks amazing. Yeah, look at that. Close up food form. Exploring Old Town Scottsdale and in the vintage store. And look, they have Chanel vintage pieces. This is like color coded, and then also by season or like types of dresses. Like gowns are in the back here, and then little black dresses. Oh,
this is VIP.
Wow!
So everything in here is a little bit more delicate, and the designers are very
more delicate.
Boston.
Holy! Look at that hat.
This dress.
Oh yeah.
Yes, that's from Bob Mackie.
I love that dress. It's beautiful.
Look at that yellow.
No, I know, it's beautiful. I would totally wear this dress. Look at this pretty cardigan feather sequin. This is so beautiful. I would totally wear this. This is so pretty. Have you ever in downtown Scottsdale? Fashion Robert Block. It's pretty cute here. And there's this really pretty pearl necklace along this mirror. Love it. So Old Town Scottsdale, it's got the old western feel. So just touring through. Ooh, too bad I'm flying. I would pick up one of those, but it probably wouldn't last long. Arizona's original western store. So it's got all your western wear, boots, hats, you name it. Getting our table prepared for dinner, but I tried the pool. This place is gorgeous. Having our dinner here.
They come so good.
Always get the burrata.
Blue cheese fondue steak.
Oh yeah. Crawled
into the microwave.
No. We are off to Unke Trail at the Usury Mountain Regional Park. So we're doing this hike. Good morning, guys. So when you're hiking, make sure you have sunnies and obviously a hat.
Yeah.
Hence,
and camera.
And camera. Because, you know, the heat, and you want to make sure your face is covered from the sun so you can not have premature aging, guys. It's so pretty. Look at this view. I mean, it's pretty. So hiking is the best thing that people love to do around here. Very health conscious, just almost like LA. So in order to put in your daily exercises, you would have to hike really early in the morning, probably around like 6, 7, or 8 before the sun comes out. and it can get to upwards of 120 degrees in Arizona. That is hot. But we're almost to the top of the trail. So maybe about 40 minutes of hiking. But yeah, it's almost like all the way up, but it's pretty, about an hour and a half, the Wind Trail Cave hike. Look at the spread. It's amazing. This is at Olive Mill in Mesa, Arizona. And now we're on to the next destination, which is actually lunch. So the other one was, they spoiled us. Joe's Farm Grill. Can't wait. Our second lunch for today. Got the grilled salmon.
We just don't want you to go hungry.
I know, thank you. Fried zucchini, and then the beet salad. And then look at Diana's salad.
Yum,
looks
yum,
amazeballs. All right, checking into our next hotel, which is the Scott Resort and Spa. Hi. Cute, cute, cute. Look at this place. Welcome, Cuban mint lemonade. Yum. And they're even pet friendly. Awesome. Here is our next hotel room. Vanity. So cute. Beautiful. And then these are adjoining rooms. Two beds here, which walks out to the patio. There you go. The adjoining room, which is here. Diana taking photos. And then, oh, here's another bathroom. Yes, I think they're like identical. So our room was super cute, you saw that. Now we're walking through the pool area, which we walked earlier, but, and look at this, so cute. It's almost like an oasis. And then here's the pool area. Super gorgeous. And now we're heading to the Jurlique Spa. So I'm excited because they're probably going to be using a lot of Jurlique items.
Hello.
Yep.
And
yes. Jurlique. I love their products.
Services. We have a little information we asked our guests to fill out for us first. Here's a little water.
Oh yeah, I heard about this new face one too, which I wanted to try as well. Alright, so I just got done my facial at Jurlique Spa here at the Scott Resort and Spa. And it was amazing. I got the enzyme resurfacing treatment, and I just learned so much from the lady, and she also talked to me about the Numi that I've been looking into and haven't really pulled the trigger. I think I want to wait for a Sephora, what is it called? The discount sale, the VIB sale, and maybe purchase one of those. But yeah, I really like the resurfacing. It was very tingly, but now my face feels so moisturized. It's been like only 2 days or so in Arizona, and we already felt, at least I felt my skin was pretty drying.
Did
you feel too?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah. How did you like your, what did you have?
I got this Vichy full body. I don't know what it was called.
How did you like it?
It was amazing.
Was it like a full body mask?
No, basically they had these overhead showers that were spraying water as she was massaging me.
As she was massaging
you? Yeah, it was amazing.
That sounds amazing.
Essential oils. Now I feel like...
Do you feel like really pampered? Because I feel super,
so pampered.
Super pampered.
Not even pampered.
Yeah. We're at happy hour right now. And look at this bonfire. And then...
my bartender made me a non-alcoholic drink. These ladies decided to have a drink up last night here, girls. Oh, I know. It's okay. Another
next
trip. Yeah.
Next body.
Woo! Yeah. And then, of course, some appetizers.
Isn't this delicious?
Hummus, pita. What is, artichoke.
Ooh. That's amazing.
Say hi to my bloggy.
I can't wait to try this.
Try it and let me know what it tastes like.
It's amazing. Oh, that goes so well.
Yeah? Good. So I just heard from the manager that they're putting $15 million in renovations into this hotel. So all the rooms will be redone. And it's gonna look like this. So it's probably gonna be like in 20, maybe later this year or next year. And then also, let me walk over to the lobby area. And that's what it's gonna look like. It's really, really cute here. And here is like the bar area. Gorgeous. So explain what this is.
So this is our scallion ash ahi tuna.
It looks so pretty.
Compressed melon, some pickled Fresnos. And then you have a melon juice in the syringes right here.
Wow.
This is a play on our salad. It's the beets and burrata.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, burrata.
Golden
okay,
beets.
Last time.
burrata cheese, strawberry vinaigrette, brioche crumb, and then some sunflower sprouts on top.
We are at Sumo Maya with my little girls. Last day here. Oh, yo, yo. So Sumo Maya is a fusion of Mexican and Asian flavors. So we're kind of excited to try this and see what we get. So I'll show you guys what we ordered. Look at my virgin lychee drink. And then what is this?
It's our margaritas.
Yes.
Sangrias.
So here is our food at Sumo Maya. We got the rainbow ceviche, which is like three types of fish in here. Here is the shrimp tempura, the bacon spinach, which I probably just eat the spinach, the lobster roll, the scallops, the Korean beef tacos, and I ordered the pescado, which is the fish tacos. It looks amazing. And then for dessert, we're having this chocolate cake, which looks delicious, with this dulce de leche caramel ice cream, and then three different flavors of mochi. Yum. Hello! So we are off to the botanical garden. It's our last day here together.
No!
It's okay. Next time we're gonna do an international.
Yes,
yeah?
We should do it.
This girl is leaving.
So we have to go
visit
her.
Yeah. So we'll show you guys around on our last day. But here the botanical garden is really pretty. And I'm looking for a big cactus that looks like this. Yeah. Like that. So we will show you what it looks like in a few minutes. Bye! Okay, we are at the garden, going to the entrance, and it's already really pretty before we even start it. Here we go. And then if you see these glass cacti, it was actually made by a very, very famous artist. I'm not sure who it is. I have to like find out from Diana. She was really impressed with them. So the sign says Chihuly, and it says Desert Towers. It's really pretty. But the method of making these is very intricate. Not a lot of people have done these before. This garden is so, so pretty. We're still looking for that big cactus. I think it's somewhere in here.
Walking. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Because remember at that Diet Coke part?
Look at this cactus. It looks so cute. At the top, it looks like a broccoli. But to me, it looks like a female. Now we're off to breakfast at the Phoenix Public Market. So excited to check it out. Look at this dessert.
Like
everything is made in-house, even the Pop-Tarts. hand dessert coming through.
Go for a reshi.
Can model.
Can model. So they're starting.
My quinoa breakfast bowl. It's amazing.
Yeah, I think they took ownership in the fall.
Fresh veggies.
And so they'll be doing renovations,
juice,
some updates.
I grab my friend's
later.
Green juice in the photo. Yeah. And then of course, there's really some pretty macarons by one who's interested.
Yeah.
But this, I'm just like killing it. But it's this chocolate cookie that's
again,
so good. And the pop tarts are really
already
good too.
Think the-
I love that they have this little garden outside the cafe. So cute. And look, a Brussels sprout plant. Tomatoes. Welcome to DeSoto Central Market. Mm. And here is tea and toast, toasted. But this is part of the, they were on Shark Tank. And then there's more market back here, Waters and Pearls, and opens up to another place. But you can actually have events here and rent out the space. It's sort of like a mini food market. Rollover donuts. Hello. This cute little gallery that's open, but this bosque plant is so cute. Hi! Cute! Good! Succulents. I think we're just looking. Love these air plants.
Are they beautiful?
They're so pretty.
We have the larger snake plants and we just got these ones in too.
Oh.
So pretty.
I love plants. I love a good winding staircase. This is so industrial. And you walk through and you have this open space for any artwork gallery. Ooh. More staircase. And this one's like see-through. Still industrial.
We're at the Phoenix Wall Street, which features all so many different wall art over there as well. You can see. And there too.
Time for lunch. And here is such a cute little garden. And then we're at the farm kitchen. So cute. And here is a little patio area for the eats. Healthy.
Yeah.
I actually might get that.
Things like that aren't local, but pretty much.
Here's lunch.
Yeah.
Super cute at this farm. The farm kitchen, very own garden that we're touring here. They have their irrigation where they water the plants. The farm at South Mountain, cute, very rustic. And the garden, oh my god, that they supply for the four restaurants that they own here in Arizona, in Phoenix area. Oh, the peeps at the farm. So these are definitely farm raised, free range.
They're Ashley that we have at the farm. She's an assistant grower here.
Oh, okay.
The farm
at South Mountain, and this is what they're growing currently, which is beets, carrots, cauliflower, broccoli, spinach, cucumber, eggplants, fennel, chard, kale, peppers, tomatoes, leeks, squash, corn, Asian greens, okra, grapefruit, oranges, tangerines, lemons, and then all sorts of herbs here. I'm so glad to see that peeps at the farm where they just use them for eggs, but they take great care of them. There's just not that many farms that do that, and I'm really happy to see that here.
They even have their own little rooster here. Hi!
And
the
oven is from
it's
France,
called
a Le Pignol oven.
For baking bread.
So that was built
and then this wall is actually put together by gravity. There's no mortar in there to keep it together. That's amazing. And we're at the Botanica, where these flowers are actually edible. Beautiful. Look at this bubble gem. There's these little bees that turn into these bubble gem. Look at that. What does it feel like? It
feels gooey and cold.
Yeah.
And delightful.